Alright guys, welcome to Choose Your Own Path. So 2 days ago we did a live video of our beaver painting. This one we're just gonna finish it up. So we have him painted, pretty much painted. It's darker from here, but I don't know how else I can show you except for when it's done. So we're gonna lighten it up. All we're gonna do is start up our machine. So what we're using is, again, our airbrush. What I want to do is I just want to give it a little bit of a lightening. So what we're going to do is we're going to take some white. Got a sponge, and with the sponge all we do is we just add water to it, our liquid, and we're going to use this as our cleaning. Instead of squeezing the tip, I'm going to use it this way. So all I want to do is lighten up the space a bit. Barely using any pressure to like to use the white. So what that's going to do is it's actually going to add almost a tinge of gray, grayish blue, because that's what we said the beaver should be. Now a little bit harder to see here, but it has the color. If we want, we could just kind of play around with the texture by taking our sponge and bringing out the color. Taking off the color, we're just kind of kind of smoothing it out. Okay. Alright. Makes it look more animal looking. My finger as a guard so that you can see the tip of his claws. Simple trick. You can see that. I'm going to do the same for the bottom of his feet. And we got his bottom of his feet have white on it. Sort of simple, just using your hands as sort of, they'll get dirty, but it's washable. Now, for the eyes, usually beaver eyes are brown. But I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna get them white. This is a hard thing to do because the lighting here is pretty hard to see, even for myself. See, we got the eyes in there. What we're going to do is we're just going to go over it with a little bit of brown. Okay. we'll take a little bit of brown. Let's go as light as we can. We're actually going to add this to our white. So that'll be a very light color brown. What we want to do is get it back low. Let's add a little bit more pressure. We're almost at no pressure. So what that brought is a lot of light brown in here. Almost like you can see that, but it's a very, very light brown. Okay. And we're just going to go over around the eye. I don't want to go too much, so we can just kind of rub it out. Again, like I said, we can use the sponge. There we have a very light face. Now, we're also going to use it to get into the mouth a bit. Because we added white to it, right? We don't want to have it too white. Just going to go over it a bit with the light brown. So that's what our beaver is. Now, just for this part, we're just gonna give it a little bit of paint. Not too much, because we want this to look like it's still the real wood. So there's our beaver. Now, hopefully when I take pictures of it, it'll look better than what I see on the camera, because I don't like the way it looks on the camera. It looks like it's really dull, and it's not. So I think the only other thing I wanted to do next was to make sure that black on the tail was dark. So what we need to do is take our black and give it a good shake. We're just going to add it to the brown because it's already a dark color. Is we're gonna give the tips of his fingers, not the tips, just before the tips, a little black, a little darkness. We definitely want his tail to be dark. So we're just gonna spray that on there, almost hoping it up. Make sure we don't get not too much on the rest of the beaver. Because our beaver has black eyes, no matter what. They always have this black, really black tingy eyes. remember, guys, when you're doing airbrushing, get good lighting happening. I have to set up better lighting than this. This is not a good lighting for me. I barely see what I'm doing here. Not barely, it just doesn't feel comfortable enough lighting. So, yeah, because, like, you can't barely see me in here. This thing, it sucks. Alright, guys, so we're just going to let this dry. And then tomorrow, we're going to go back to the other shop and we're going to epoxy him. So, we're going to let him dry. Like I said, I just got a little bit of black left. I'm just going to highlight maybe a little bit of the wood. Some spots, darken it up, maybe a little bit on the top, definitely make the wood look a little bit darker. Alright, so there we go. The Beaver's done. Now all it needs to do is get a coat of epoxy on it, and it's ready to be sent out. So we'll get back to you.